Well, hello, Glue Troopers. Max and Max's Models here. I'm in colorful Atlanta, Georgia, in the hotel. And if you hear sirens and street noises in the background, there's nothing I can do about it. It's the real thing. So, I did bring that little 1/72 scale Tempest with me from Revell. And I got to tell you what, the kit was really better than I expected. Went together very easily. Now, of course, I didn't finish building it because I have to be able to paint it. And it wouldn't transport well all in one piece, so the landing gear is off of it and everything, and the wings pop off. But it went together with no arguments. They're good moldings. My hat's off to the mold makers. That kit goes back to the 60s. And I also was impressed not only with how good the fit and everything was, which was not always Revell's strong suit, but also how well it just, the proportions and everything are, just it just looked good. And I believe it was Mike Machat had told me that the Revell went more for the optical. In other words, they might actually make a model that was slightly misproportioned if it looked better. Because you have to remember that companies like Tamiya that make the kit absolutely nut for rivet off the engineering drawings, some people sometimes complain about how they look. And that's because you don't perceive a small model the same way you perceive a full-size object. And sometimes when you scale them down, if you change proportions just a little bit, it actually looks better. So, anyway, I got done with that so quickly that I decided, you know what, I'm going to go ahead and take a look at these other three models. And as long as I'm on these other three models, let me tell you a slight little embarrassment. I had an overnight in Fort Lauderdale. I knew I was going to be meeting up with my buddy Ken. I gave him the decals that I made for the Bowmark. And he brought three kits that he'd gotten at the train club and at a sale. The total was $5 for these three kits. One of them even had a 50-cent price tag on it, and it's Apache. So it didn't even dawn on me. I didn't really have to bring a model. And when I got to the room and started looking at the stuff, I opened up my little travel kit and realized in my rush, I did not grab glue. I was meant to get the Tamiya quick dry. I actually grabbed Mark Fit by mistake. Nope. Although I did wind up using it on when I put started on the Apache, which we'll talk about in a minute. So the next day I went down to 7-Eleven, grabbed some. The only glue they had that would work was Loctite, but I figured that'll do. So I had a long sit here in Atlanta, which I'm on right now. And I went ahead and just started working. That's where I built the Tempest. And it went right together without any argument. And so it went together so quickly, I was like, well, I got plenty of time. And I looked at these other kits, the P-51 and the BF-109 from Ertl. Now, these are originally Otaki kits from Japan. And I decided, you know what, those have to be fully painted and everything, a lot of detail. Where it's going to be better if I do something else. But the AMT Ertl Apache, which is really an original Eshi Ertl kit from the late 80s, 1/72 scale, it's in green. I can go ahead and get started on that. And putting the cockpit together was quite a trick. The parts fit okay. I'm not putting that internal glass part in yet because I don't want the CA glue to fog it up. Also, I have to paint the interior. The decals were oversized. The ones that go inside had to be trimmed way down below their actual size to fit. They had trouble clinging. They're kind of old, so there's that. But not terribly impressed with the decals I've used so far. But at least they did hold together, so there's that. Design-wise, not a bad. It's kind of a meh kit. It's not bad. It's also not great. It's just, you know, it's a competent, Apache's a competent kit. Some of the parts are super delicate on it. Reasonably good detail. You know, no real complaints there. And it's, you know, if you want 1/72 scale Apache, it's fine. It's not going to win any awards, but there's nothing really quote-unquote wrong with it. The little gap seal is going to be needed and stuff. You know, usual stuff. No complaints there. And I look forward to building the Mustang. I have two other Mustangs, the Profi Pack and the other Monogram / Revell kit I was given, which I had built once before when I did that comparison build. And I'm going to add this one in the comparison build just to have one more model to look at and compare it to. And overall, I'm kind of impressed with the Otaki kits. Plastic sometimes a little brittle. AMT plastic on the Apache was a skosh on the brittle side, but nothing you can't deal with. So that's what we got. There's the road builds as I have them so far. Really can't go any further with them because I have to ship them. And I thought you guys might just enjoy seeing what I was up to in the hotel room. I hope everybody is doing well. And we'll talk to everybody later. You guys take care of yourselves. And I'll just play a little music here while I show you some pictures in the outro. Remember, I'm doing this on my cell phone, so not my usual stellar standards of video production, but hey, it's all in fun, right? You guys take care. We'll see you later, and as always, muddle on.